it's a big deal for them to leave country. And so it was really nice to sort of see that sort of human element outside the ice rink.
Okanagan filmmaker Nigel Edwards and his team have spent the last 4 years developing the film called Closing the Gap, Hockey in North Korea.
The film follows the North Korean men's national team from Pyongyang all the way to New Zealand during the 2017 IIHF tournament. The film's trying to frame an individual amongst a group and a regime that's not really conducive to individuality. Once you're kind of there, it's sort of jump back in time. You know, it's back in the 1950s sort of era, Soviet style. This film's not really an essay on North Korea, and I don't expect anybody to come away with a full breadth of knowledge about the country or the regime. It's really trying to be a small look at just a group of individuals who happen to play hockey, who also happen to be from North Korea. And one of my producers put it perfectly. He says, it's really a small tile in the sort of grand mosaic that is North Korea. It's quite humbling to sort of be able to connect with other people on the other side of the world, not speaking the same language, and to use it was really a masterclass in nonverbal communication, being able to sort of like play games with them and laugh and have fun. The players themselves, much to people's sort of dismay, like they all have their own kind of unique qualities. We really got quite embedded with these players over the course of, you know, 3 years. And they say that the first time you show up, you're a stranger, the second time you're a friend, and the third time you're welcome back as family. Our film is pretty unique in the sense that it was the first time a film crew has ever been embedded with a national team to travel in country and abroad. There have been actually quite a number of films that have come out of North Korea, all kind of looking at different aspects of life. Unlike our film though, most of those films have been either censored or reviewed. None of our footage was looked at. We didn't have to review any kind of governmental authority. One of the, my biggest takeaways for this film has certainly been just the humility and the intentionality of these players. When you stand in front of them, they're looking you in the eyes. And while they do have cell phones, it's they're very present with you. And it really kind of set the bar high for me when I came back to Canada to sort of, you know, be more intentional with my relationships and those types of things.
The film will be premiering worldwide at the Whistler Film Festival on December 5th and 6th. For Castanet News, I'm Miriam Halpenny in Kelowna.